BikeBlogger. On my way to work. Sort of. First we're gonna go to the park. And then we'll go to work. Cause why not? Little detour is always fun. As you can tell, it's rainy today. It's not raining now though, it's just wet. And we'll go to the park. Really a turning lane here, but we'll stop in the middle anyway. Or we'll just put out our arm signal and we'll make a left. Gotta be really careful though, because the paint is wet. What do I mean by that? I'm not saying that the paint is new or anything. It's just when you get water on paint, like, I don't know, plastic? I don't know, what is paint made out of? Sort of a plasticky material. They're doing work over here. Taking down a tree or something. Peace on earth. Yeah, so they are doing lights around in this park now, I guess. It's hard to believe already this year that they're doing it. Installing the Christmas lights. But they usually have each year around here are holiday lights, Christmas lights, whatever we call them. They have a thing called Winter Wonderland. And it's a chance for people to take their family to the park at night, and it's all lit up with Christmas lights. Yeah. Nasty water. So as you can see, they're starting to put some stuff out over there. There's some sort of thing over there. And I thought I was gonna stop and talk to you a little bit. Oh, there's the park benches. Let's go over there. And today's topic is bicycle maintenance. So we're gonna go over that. Now, I used to have a list or like a schedule for doing bike maintenance on my bike, but like every person, this is sort of funny. Season's greedy? Huh. People can be pretty greedy sometimes. Yeah, let's go, let's look. These are Christmas lights. So, this is my bike. This is a Motobicon. Not really, I mean it is sort of, but it's not really because it's not a true Motobicon. It's a Motobicon USA. That is an internet bike. Although I've totally blinged it out, so to speak. I got a whole bunch of aftermarket stuff on it, and it's worth a lot more than the bike that it was originally. To me, at least. Still a single speed. I love single speed. Okay, here we go. Let's stop here for a second. Bicycle maintenance. Every ride, pre-ride, pump tires, check brakes. Post-ride, wipe down the chain, wipe down the bike, recharge light batteries. So that's good advice. I do advise doing that. The screech. I do advise doing that every time you ride. Every week, it says here, add lube to chain, wipe off pulleys, wipe off chain rings, wipe down bike. Check tires, recharge your batteries again. So, batteries, batteries, batteries. So many things have batteries nowadays. Every month, degrease, detail the drivetrain, and wash your bike and lube your chain. All right, now we're getting into more of the deeper things here, where you might need some specialty tools. It says every few months, replace the chain, lubricate pedals and cleats, lubricate your shifters and brake pivots, remove and clean the cassette. That does require some specialty tools. Let's see what else. Check all bolts for proper tightness. Replace chain every 6 months. Replace cleats and bar tape every 6 months. So yeah, this is a pretty detailed list. I'll have a link in the description below about this. I ripped it off of Slow Twitch. That's a website. Anyway, every year replace racing tires. I mean, I think the Slow Twitch website is like a triathlete website. So a lot of this probably wouldn't apply. Replace aero bars. I mean, who commutes with aero bars? I don't think a lot of people do that. Reapply grease to your seat post every year. Definitely recommend that, especially if you have a metal on metal. You know, those things can fuse together, aluminum and steel. Every 2 years, replace headset bearings, service your wheel hubs, replace your disc brake rotors, replace most pedals and saddles every 2 years. Maybe, you know, it depends on how much you ride. And if you got multiple bikes like me, then, you know, you might be able to stretch out some of the service work. So thanks for watching. All right, let's continue with my commute today on this beautiful day. Nice and cloudy and wet everywhere. As I said, it rained. It might rain again today. Especially on days like this, it's a good idea to think about bike maintenance. If you got rim brakes like this bike has, and you're riding in the wet, make sure that you clean your wheel rims or wipe them down. Wipe down your brake pads a little bit after you ride in the wet, because your braking surfaces will get dirty real quick. Not as big of a deal with disc brakes, but with rim brakes like this, traditional bicycle rim brakes, it is sort of a big deal. Whew. So we're on our way to work now. Hopefully we can still get through up here. I didn't know they were beginning work this early. It's only October 12, a Wednesday right now. I wonder, what do you think? On a day like today, should I have my bike lights on? Answer, you should probably have your bike lights on every day when you're out riding, because you're only gonna be more visible, you know. Only thing you gotta worry about there is battery life. If you have somewhere where you can charge your light batteries at your destination, then why not use your, you know, your lights every day, right? Or every time you ride. Okay, so make a left, I guess. We're leaving the park now. Not a lot of traffic. We'll just go straight. In a moment here, you'll see where I usually link up with my bicycle commute, where I hit record and I say, "Bike Blogger here on my way to work on this beautiful Wednesday morning." Nobody around for the most part. up the hill. Is the bike blogger amazing at bike maintenance? Absolutely not. I could do a lot better with my bikes. Will it be a good start? Probably working on the chain some more. Guy didn't have to pass me, that's okay, I'm over too far. Gotta get more in the middle here to avoid that. There he goes. I turn my light on, get my light going. Getting a little spooky, seeing more Halloween decorations. That guy was sort of ticking me off. I think he was purposely hitting stop and sitting at the light extra long there. Shouldn't let people, you know, tick you off, but even the bike blogger gets ticked off occasionally. It's like, come on, man. You break the law by crossing the double yellow, getting in front of me, and then you like obnoxiously obey the law by stopping at a stop sign when no one's at the intersection and sitting there for like an extra 5 seconds or something. It's like, come on, dude, you don't have to do that to me. Don't do me like that. Don't do me like that. Oh, it's all good. Alright. Out to the bigger road. Make sure my lights are on. All right. There we go. Da, 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 da. And here I go. Now I'm gonna cross the double yellow. Exit only. Oh, bike blogger. You're breaking the rules. I don't like to say that, you know, oh, runners are idiots, you know, running in the road when there's a sidewalk. Oh, cyclists are idiots, riding in the road when there's a sidewalk. Drivers of motor vehicles are idiots, driving in the road when there's a sidewalk. But I think people in general can be sort of stupid sometimes. And I wouldn't, you know, take a certain class of people and say they're just stupid, because that's just stupid. So anyway, way off topic now. Let's get back onto bicycle maintenance. So what do I do after I've ridden in a rainstorm? Well, dry off the bike or wipe down the bike. Just use a towel. You can use the same towel. You don't have to clean the towel every time you wipe down the bike. Put some new fresh lube on the chain, just a little bit. You don't need a lot, just a little. One of those things where I say you don't actually need a ton of lubrication, something external like that, a chain. Wipe down the braking surfaces, maybe clean them if you think you have to with some isopropyl alcohol. You can get all sorts of junk in your brake pads in this sort of weather, so again, particularly, well, both types of brake pads, but particularly rim brake pads, So since they're just exposed, you know, you can see them really easily, especially if you take the wheel out. Double check, make sure there's absolutely no grit and stuff embedded in there, because that's what's gonna really cause your rim braking surface on your wheel to wear down pretty fast. And you don't wanna have to prematurely replace your wheel or wheels, because wheels are set of expensive, probably one of the most expensive components on a bike. And why is that? Because the bike's going nowhere without wheels. At least for now, until they get those hover bikes out there more mainstream. So it's looking pretty good right now. I mean, I can actually see some sunlight. I obviously see sunlight, otherwise this video wouldn't come out very well. But I can see some sun peeking through the clouds up ahead. Take a left. So about this particular bike, I'll link in the description below about this bike. Probably wondering, like, what sort of tires am I riding? They're just Continental Gator Skin, a touring tire, and they're skinny to fit the fenders. They're 23 mil, so really skinny. Really skinny. I go straight here. Like my time of day, looks like it's gonna change green for us. Maybe they get a little further ahead here. Those guys got a green, but he's going left. There we go. If you have any bicycle maintenance questions, leave them in the comment section below. I will try to answer them. What's going on here? I think they actually are putting down some fresh paint. Watch out, that's dangerous. Stinks too. I wonder if they used Lowe's paint. Probably not. I'm sure you need some sort of really, well, not really, but some somewhat special paint for roads, outdoors. Go around this way. People out shopping on a rainy day. Oh, the garden department's closed. Gates are shut. Oh. I must admit, I am a little, these skinny tires and these high pressures, I'm a little nervous about taking tight corners. Gotta really make sure your body weight is positioned properly on the bike. Dun, dun, dun. Yes, I do have my light on. It's hard to see though, it's bright outside. I mean, it's somewhat bright. Alright. Okay, let's see how we're doing in time. It's getting sort of late. We need to get to work here. We'll go straight toward the garbage truck. See, Oh, there's one other thing I wanted to check out today. And that is, what the heck is going on with this road? Not this one, but the one over one from here. I'll zip over and show you in a second. What I think is going on with this road is that they're installing new utilities underground. Or not really, but new pipes. But they're also installing sidewalks. And I'm not sure if there's ever been real sidewalks along Manchester Road in this section, so I'll show you in a moment. But I think they're gonna be doing work on it until next spring. So it's a major deal here. It's a major deal. It's gonna take quite a while for them to finish. I don't know what the particular difficulties are, except for that it's difficult. If not, let's make a right. I don't always signal, I try to signal, but gotta keep my hands on the brakes at all times, so it's often possible. Yeah, my brakes are making the noise right now because they're not particularly super clean. Tried to clean them, but I need to do a better job at that. Okay, so let's make a left here, I think. See where this takes us. I do not believe this road is completely open. I believe it's still closed to through traffic up here, but let's see. What we'll end up probably doing is cutting through. Yeah, see, road closed. Huh. I probably could cut through there. Lights green and everything, but I think there's a guy in that. I wasn't really paying attention, but I think there's a guy in that heavy machinery thing, a backhoe. And bike versus backhoe. Backhoe wins. So we're not doing that. Not today at least. Go back, water go. Light is red, I'm not slowing anybody down. And the rain is beginning. Woo! There goes light. Let's make a right. Show. Oh man. I knew it was gonna rain today, but I didn't think it'd be this soon. As usual, the weather guys are all wrong. It wasn't supposed to rain early in the morning. Be careful here, I'm still going backwards. So here, it's really gravelly though, so be careful. Trash truck. Another one. Wasn't supposed to rain early this morning before my commute, and it wasn't supposed to rain during my commute. It was just supposed to rain around lunchtime. So we'll see. It might just be a rainy day all day today, off and on. Try to follow the weather report. They're not always correct, but I did know for sure I needed my bike with rain fenders today, my rain bike. Few more cars and we'll be on our way. Oh, signaling with a hand on a bumpy road. Be careful out there, guys and gals. Hey! Hey! We'll see you next time.